Hey, how's it going, everyone? My name's Nick DeMarco. I'm going to be your new professor for the remainder of the semester. I'm taking over for Joe Kwan. Joe and I met each other last semester, and I had a long conversation with him this afternoon about where, his ideas for this course were and where my ideas are at. And he told me kind of the plan and what he had spoke to you all about and what you guys have been learning. And so I'm going to do my best to make sure that no new surprises come out of this, that I honor what his commitments were and all of that to you, and we try and make this transition as smoothly as possible. Now, with that being said, this kind of fell into my lap this weekend, and I've got to be honest, I've got a really big advanced statistics test on Tuesday. And so I just kind of fell a little bit behind, which is why I'm doing this recording, which is about me. Rather than meeting with all of you in person. And so, if you could just give me one more day to kind of refresh myself with what Joe's been doing and the study plans and look at his syllabus, I promise we're going to make this transition as easy as possible. So, what I thought would be a great, introduction is for you to see a video on me about who I am. And that's kind of a way that now when we meet, in person or via other videos, there's a face to the name, and you get to know a little bit about me. So, this is me, Nicholas DeMarco. I'm a graduate student here at Cal State Fullerton. I got my bachelor's degree at Sacramento State University. I got it in kinesiology. We did exercise science, and I had a concentration in strength and conditioning. Like I previously alluded to, I am a grad student here at Cal State Fullerton. I work with Dr. Andy Galpin. These are some of the people that we had in our lab last semester, as well as Dr. Kevin and Dr. Jimmy Bagley, who's at San Francisco State. We were out at Cal State Panoma, cutting up muscle tissue. And so what I'm really interested in, what we've been studying in Dr. Galpin's lab, is molecular signaling, cell signaling in response to exercise physiology. And so what we do is we get a bunch of you students who want to get a personal trainer, a nutritionist, get free supplements, and we take a muscle biopsy. So we cut into your quad, we take a little bit of your muscle, we freeze it, and then we put you on a training plan and a diet plan for X amount of weeks. And then post-exercise intervention, we take another muscle biopsy, and then we study the before and after. We look at those muscle cells and see what the chemistry has done under the influence of the training regimen that we've had, the diet that we've had you on, and see what kind of changes we make. Really cool stuff. Unfortunately, down now because of COVID, a lot of that is on hold, but hopefully, next fall, maybe we'll get human research back up and running. And so if that's kind of interesting to you, feel free to come volunteer at our lab. We're always looking for volunteers. Or if that sounds like maybe that's an idea of what you want to get into, take a look at Dr. Andy Galpin's work. Feel free to reach out to me and see how you would best, find your way along that path. I'm from Philadelphia. Go Birds. We're getting stomped right now. It's Friday. I'm originally from Philadelphia. I love the Eagles, as you can see with my jersey. That's my wife and I in front of the Art Museum in Philadelphia, the Rocky statue. I made my way out this way to California because I joined the military. So I was in the Air Force for 11 years and I was stationed in South Dakota. That's an actual picture of me and my buddies working out on B-1 bombers on the left in the negative 80 degrees and snow outside for like 8 months out of the year. And I said, I don't want to do that anymore. And so I went and I got some education and I became a flight engineer and I flew on KC-10s. So I actually sat between the pilots, did all their math, did all the takeoff and landing stuff, controlled the throttles, pumped all the gas. We would refuel other airplanes, right? So that's a picture I actually took out of our window of all those F-16s. An F-16 can fly for about 2 hours before it runs out of gas. And so you may think to yourself, how the hell do we get them all the way over to the Middle East? Do we get them to Japan? Do we get them to Europe? Well, they fly right beside us, and once an hour or so, they fly behind us, and we've got a giant hose that comes up and they connect, and then we pump them some of our gas. So I did air-to-air refueling. Yep, two airplanes within 40 feet of each other going about 600 miles an hour at about 30,000 feet in the air. Really dangerous, really scary stuff, but it was really awesome. I had a great experience. I traveled the world and I loved it. After about 11 years, the military cut its budget and they cut one of the airplanes and the one that I flew on. And so after 11 years, I thought I was going to make it my full-time gig and retire. They said, "Hey, Nick, sorry, we don't need you anymore. Thanks for your service. See you later." So I found myself at 30 years old without any real education and a job that didn't transfer into the civilian world. I don't know if you guys know this, but there's no such thing as air refueling in the civilian sector. So I didn't know what I was going to do. I was lucky enough, though, that in my time in the military, I'd worked with some special forces people. I got to go to a special forces school myself, and I saw the exercise component that those men and women put themselves through. And it started this path of, wow, that science is really cool. And so when I got out, I decided, let's go back to school and let's get on this exercise physiology path. But how am I going to go ahead and set myself apart, right? I'm getting out at 30. You guys are all 19, 18. When I go up against an employer, what's going to separate me from the rest of you? Well, I took my time and my management skills that I had had in the military, took the money that I had saved, and I opened up my own gym and I just started competing very, very aggressively. Traveled around the country and met with some of the greatest coaches and shadowed under them. And so I was a competitive weightlifter. I opened up a weightlifting gym, an Olympic weightlifting gym in the Bay Area, qualified for national events, went to the American Open, and then just went to every single gym and found every coach that I could and just tried to bug the hell out of them until they told me all their secrets. And so there's Cal Strength in the bottom right-hand corner. Dave Spitz was one of my big mentors in both coaching and a business sense. Trained alongside Wes Kitz, Rob Blackwell, Stefan Ngo, Nicole Lim. Wes is going to be our next Olympian. Rob, multiple national medalist. Nicole, international medalist. So really strong group of people there. As I said, I opened up my gym. I first started a CrossFit gym, and then I opened up an Olympic weightlifting and powerlifting, more strength-based type gym. On the left, that's my CrossFit gym. On the right, that's my strength training type gym. I also worked with a lot of military special forces people, and I still own the Four Horsemen strength and conditioning side, doing online training for Olympic weightlifters, powerlifters, bodybuilders, and I still do consulting for the military, with special forces type groups. Selfless plug again. That's the one that we're most active on. The CrossFit gym is shut down. You can't find anything because CrossFit makes you turn in all of your licensing rights. The Four Horsemen strength and conditioning is still going on. Like I said, the big thing that I do is mainly still coach Olympic weightlifting. I still compete in it from time to time, but I've taken a backseat from my endeavors of a competitor, and I'm mo mainly coach now. And so I still have a team that we travel all over the country. This is me with one of my youth athletes. I think she was 14 or 15 at the time. We travel all over the country going to these meets. That's Lily. She's been training with me since she was 12. Yeah, it's a lot of fun. Still some other pictures traveling around. This is the whole team. We were in Vegas a couple years ago before COVID shut down. This is what I do primarily for my job. Also, while I was at Sac State, I was the vice president of their barbell club. This is our barbell club at Sac State called Stinger Barbell Club. We were the biggest club on campus. We had over 400 members that were interested in weightlifting, powerlifting, bodybuilding, and strongman. And that was really like a lot of fun too. We did meets all over the place and we hosted our own meet. And that's what this was from after that weekend. I live in Sacramento. So, I was stationed out at Travis Air Force Base, opened up my gym in the Bay Area, sold all of that so that I could pursue my degree in kinesiology up at Sac State. And I decided I didn't want to live in Bay Area anymore, so I bought a house up in Sacramento. Last semester, I was doing the full-time commuting, or not commuting, but I was living in Fullerton and flying back to see my wife, who still lives in Sacramento. And when COVID happened, we just decided, hey, we're not going to do that dual rent, dual mortgage thing anymore. We're just going to live in Sacramento. So, unfortunately, I can't probably meet very many of you face to face this semester. I'm up in Sacramento. Looks like we're going to be up here next semester as well, but maybe eventually we'll get down to Fullerton again. Like I said, I have a wife. I got married last year. We both met while we were in the military. We dated for, almost 8 years before we decided to get married. We opened up these businesses together. Like I said, she was an ER nurse in the military. She's the true badass in this. You can see from this picture right here, I was kind of lounging up in the airplane, being Gucci as hell, flying around the world, doing my thing. Whereas she was an ER trauma nurse. She went to Afghanistan, take care of all of these special forces guys who were wounded, all of the soldiers, both on the Afghani side and on our side. So one of the things that not very many people know about is that America helps anybody who's in time of war. And so even if we got people who were the bad guys showing up to our hospitals over in Afghanistan, we believe that life is the most important thing. And so we treated them and made sure that they got the help that they need. And then we dealt with, you know, their negative consequences afterwards, whether or not they went to jail or whatever. But she was truly badass. She's an ER trauma nurse now, not in the military, still out there saving lives. We rescued two pugs while we were together as well. They're both Eagles fans, as you can see, right? She's a Patriots fan. She's from Boston. Boo, get out of here. Tom Brady sucks. Although he's looking pretty good right now. That's Liko and Amrap. There are two pugs. And then this summer, driving across country, we came across a trailer park out in Nevada that had all these little puppies that had never been brought inside, who had dug a hole to try and escape the 120 degree heat out there. And we went up to the trailer and said, hey, what are you guys doing with these puppies? And they said, you can take them. We don't have room for them. And that's why they're sitting out in the yard. And so we rescued one of them. Wish we could have taken them all. We just couldn't. So that's Lazar. We're out there in Nevada. So that's really it about me. Like I said, this semester, crazy for everyone, right? And especially crazy for you all, having a new professor come in and take over your class. If you guys have any questions whatsoever, please email me. Joe's a really good, great guy. I hope the best, you know, happens and he continues doing what he's got to do and taking care of his life. But I'm really honored that the university reached out to me and said, hey, would you like to pick up these two classes? And so all I ask is that you give me a little bit of patience to try and get caught up to speed. Understand that I'm getting thrown into this just like you guys are getting me thrown onto you. And as a result, I'm going to be very, very lenient, and we're going to try and work this out. And so if there are any questions, comments, concerns, anything like that, please feel free to reach out to me. I want to do my best to make sure that this transitions smooth for everyone. I will be shooting out an email later, probably Tuesday, about what we're going to do for Wednesday, whether we meet in person or I just hold office hours for a couple hours. And if you want to swing on in and say hi, introduce yourself, totally cool. I know that Joe had been primarily just recording things and putting them up that way. So I'm open. If you guys want to meet in person, if you want me to just continue the way that Joe's doing it, let me know. Like I said, stay tuned. I'll send out an email with some more further plans from them, but in the meantime, feel free to reach out to me. Thanks a lot for watching this video. Try to keep it under 10 minutes. I went over a little longer, but that's all we got. Go Birds. Hope everyone's having a good weekend.